That's better. Move the bit a little bit so that he is softer in the neck. That's better.
Yeah.
That's better.
More uphill.
Yeah, yeah. You know, when they go out too much in the passage, it encourages them not to bend their joints as well when they go out against your hands. So you have to really soften and let go, soften and let go. Yeah, because you want him to get into a place that he's doing it for himself. So you're pulling on him every time in the up. So I want you to ground him and let go fairly frequently, and then use your seat or your leg or your whip to say, you keep going. That's it. That's it. Can you feel the difference?
Yeah.
Yeah. That sometimes you have to sit against the horse to get him not to cover so much ground, but you really don't want the mechanic. And then when you come down the next long side, push him together with a shorter, for a shorter step. And then put him into shoulder in. And keep your right hand down and to the right. Keep the right hand down and to the right. Take the heel on the right hand. That's better, just at the end of pushing. And then ask him for a little bit of lengthening. Maybe to be. Good, now push him together. As if you were shortening him, use your leg first. Good, keep it quick. That's good. And then do a shoulder in. And come around the corner and really make sure your right hand stays down and fairly right. And keep it quick. Now that's a better shoulder in. Is that clear to you?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. And then a 10-meter circle. And keep your right hand down. And organize him with your seat around. Keep your right hand down. Keep pushing him. Yep, make that circle again. And push him a little bit more with your inside leg. And bend him a little bit with your inside rein.
Even though
you're keeping your right hand down. And shoulder in again. Keep your right hand down and away.
Good.
Super. And walk for a second.
Wow.
Now that's a better canter. Is
yes.
that clear?
Yeah.
Good. Good. And then make a 10-meter circle here. And go. Use that outside rein. Say, come along, baby. Bend a little bit. Good. 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 Bend him a little bit. Use your outside rein down to the bending and pushing more to the outside rein. That's it. Super. Good. Take him away. Could you feel how that gave him more space to jump under with his hind leg? Okay. But that's one of the reasons why you want to put a little bit of weight and come back here on the right knee and half off on the outside rein and then get. Good.
Good.
So you really have to be quick, strong, and then out of there. Good. Get with your right side, pushing him into the left rein a bit. Good. And put him in shoulder four. So you have to take him a little bit with the left rein over and your right side pulling, and then give, and then take him again, and then give, and then take him again and give. That's it. Yeah. Now he starts to go there because he's doing it rather than you're doing it, huh? Yeah, and then say shoulder four. Don't be too much on that left shoulder. There is, as we've explained before, too much of a good thing. Good. And then smaller the circle until it's 10 meters. And go, and now I'm going to use that left rein to take you around. But I'm going to be bending. And I'm going to take you around with my left seat and right seat to the right. Left hand says, in an uptick, go left. Go left. Go left. Yeah, that would be better. Have to get some bend, but you can see that you need to get him steered with the outside rein when his front feet are off the ground.
Yeah.
When they're on the ground, nothing's going to happen. Good. And then come away into a large circle. Super boy.
Good boy.
Super boy. Good boy. And come back to walk. Because when he makes that... Four half past. dead straight. I mean, bending makes half pass easier to do. But you've got to make the horse aware of that. And one of the really good ways of making the horse aware of that is doing, oh, maybe a 15-meter circle with haunches in, making a 10-meter circle bend without haunches in. I mean, if you can do it with haunches in,